Can the third episode of Loki uphold the high standard the first two episodes laid out? And will we learn more about the plans of the female variant of Loki? Hi there, it's Micha. Come in and find out. This week's video will be quite short in comparison, because I'm going to a film festival from Thursday to Sunday, which keeps me pretty much busy the whole time. This will also mean that the serious talk with my sister might happen either later, which would mean around Tuesday next week, or we will just skip over that one and create one for episodes 3 and 4 together, which might make more sense. We will see. I guess this week I will also not include any video clips or images just because of a time issue that I'm facing. Sorry about that. In any case, the next videos will be a little bit more detailed again. Let's get to the synopsis. Last week's episode ended with Loki following the female variant through the time door that she opened. To our surprise, this door leads directly into the TVA, where she just starts fighting the guards. Loki, on the other hand, is doing what we expect from him. He is, on one hand, trying to stop her on behalf of the TVA, but also trying to recruit her, because that's just his nature. As Ravonna joins the fight, shooting at both of them, Loki and the female variant are stumbling through a time portal right into the backyard of another apocalypse, the Moon Lamentis, in 2077, right before a planet is about to crash into that moon. Unfortunately, the Tempad, the device they can use to jump through time and space, is out of power, and they need a source to recharge it. Since Loki has hidden it with magic, they are forced to team up to find a power source. Their plan is pretty straightforward. There is a shuttle trying to leave the planet. Unfortunately, it will not succeed, but it will have enough power to charge the pad. So they sneak their way onto a train that leads them directly to the shuttle. Unfortunately, on the train, Loki gets drunk and raises suspicion, so some guards come by and kick them out of a train. The Tempad does not survive this fall. Depressed and with just a few hours until the moon gets crushed by the planet, the female variant, which has identified herself as being called Sylvie, is about to give up. But Loki has an idea. They could still try to get to the shuttle, and though nobody was able to leave the moon before, he suggests that maybe the two of them can make the shuttle succeed where it failed before. Latching on that Hail Mary attempt, Sylvie is on board and Loki and her are heading to the shuttle. The show ends with the shuttle unfortunately being destroyed and the two of them being stuck there facing certain death. This episode is all about getting to know the variant called Sylvie, and basically only features two of the main characters, her and Loki. Though we have a short scene where Hunter C20 and also Ramona Renslayer are appearing, but those are just a few seconds. The show makes really good use of the episodic structure, like WandaVision did with the different decades dedicated to sitcoms. Here we have a clear chapter 1, where Loki is being captured and learns about being a variant and the Time Variant Authority. The second chapter is all about him and his first missions, until he jumps through the door following the female Loki. And this chapter is all about the two of them getting to know each other and connecting on some level, even if they are unwillingly joining forces. This chapter also has a different tone because it feels like a buddy movie, because it's just the two of them forced to depend on each other, like in the classic movies. The next episode either needs to follow their storyline because they are stranded on that moon. It can also switch back to the TVA and shows the aftermath of Sylvie sending back those time charges and creating chaos on the sacred timeline, or it might be a mix of both of them, which I guess would be the most logical way to do it, because otherwise the series might run out of time to explain everything that it sets out to do. In this episode we learn quite a lot from Sylvie, especially that she doesn't appear to be as hostile as previously expected. To cut to the chase, this episode was a little bit shorter than the previous ones with 41 minutes. It went a completely different way than I expected, but it was nevertheless very entertaining and on the point. So sorry to disappoint you, I'm going again with an 8.5 out of 10 points for this one, even though, as mentioned before, it is completely different than the previous two episodes. But it's always good to have something a little bit different than the stuff you saw before, otherwise it's getting boring and repetitive. Some quick callouts regarding the theories we touched on before. but more details on those in the next videos as well. So we discussed if this variant is Lady Loki or maybe the Enchantress. So it seems to be that it is neither, because in the comics there is a person called Sylvie, which is given power by Loki and sent out to create chaos, even though she is not aware of it. And she is emulating the powers that the original Enchantress character has, which was a mighty sorceress who was one of the main villains in the Thor saga. If this Sylvie really has the same storyline or something similar, which the fact that she is named Sylvie highly suggests, we will find out in the next episodes. We know about her though that she has a completely different upbringing and her timeline is completely different from our Loki, which of course was obvious because she is a female variant, but also her whole backstory is different as well. She also lets us know by way of telling a story about Hunter C-20. Despite what Mobius was told and he told Loki, the Minutemen were not created by the Timekeepers. But everyone inside the TVA apparently are variants which memories were just erased. Which means we were pretty spot on with our prediction in the last videos. One other interesting callout is that she is calling the Timekeepers and the TVA fascists. So either they are not the good guys as we are thinking, or she has experienced something really bad in her past. Either way, she is, like so many villains in the MCU, someone who has either an understandable backstory or is not a villain at all. Maybe the TVA and the Timekeepers turn out to be the bad guys. Another quick callout is about the blonde from the trailer that we discussed in the last Serious Talk video, where we said, could that likely be Black Widow? But after Sylvie dropped her cape in this episode, we could see her costume, and this from behind looks pretty much the same as something that Black Widow would wear. So we can be pretty sure that the screenshot is showing her and Loki. One last call out before I close this video is something I forgot last time, and that is that this show is the first one that actually shows us the future in the MCU, because last time we saw the apocalypse of 2050 and this time we see the apocalypse of 2077. I think we have never seen the future in any other MCU entity at all. So that is something new that might be interesting, might be giving us ideas where the show is heading, but since it is so far in the future, maybe it's completely irrelevant. But I think it's noteworthy that it is, as I think, the first show that shows us the future. That's it for this week. Let me know in the comments if you agree with this rating and what your rating would be. As always, if you enjoyed this video, feel free to like it and share it with your friends. And why not subscribe to my channel so you won't miss any future video. Make sure to also hit the notification bell so that you get a heads up whenever a new video is posted. So much for now, hear you next time, and thanks for listening!